How's it going, guys? We have a medium difficulty question for dermatology slash pediatrics. I'll stay consolidated, not waste your fucking time. So before we get started, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. Give the video a like. I really appreciate it. Find me on Instagram at mehlman underscore medical, mehlman underscore medical. Links down below. Find me on Telegram. The links to the Telegram group and channel are down below. Now start the clip. 12-year-old girl. She has a 2-day history of redness, pain, and warmth of her right arm. Physical exam shows an 8 by 14 centimeter area of erythematous excoriated skin over the right intercubital fossa. She has a history of asthma and seasonal allergies. Temperature is 100 Fahrenheit. Question wants to know the most likely explanation for this patient's presentation. Let's just walk through the answer choices here. Choice A, chronic mucocutaneous candidiasis. Wrong fucking answer. I have seen this show up on nbme as a 17-year-old girl who has a 1-year history of autoimmune thyroiditis, 2-year history of type 1 diabetes mellitus, and candidal skin infection since birth. They want you to know that autoimmune diseases go together, and that autoimmune diseases and immunodeficiencies go together. For example, celiac disease, IgA deficiency, type 1 diabetes mellitus, vitiligo, okay? So they can throw any mix that they want into the picture there. Student will say, oh, but the candidal infections could be from the diabetes. As you just said, it's not. I said 2-year history of diabetes, but she's had a candidal skin infection since birth, okay? It's a long fucking discussion. Point is, wrong answer. Choice B, contact dermatitis, wrong answer. Type 4 hypersensitivity, T-cell response. USMLE wants you to know weeds, poison ivy, poison oak, poison sumac, linear vesicles, and someone who went gardening or hiking, nickel from watches, sunscreen, PPD test for tuberculosis, okay? Wrong fucking answer. Choice C, lymphangitis, wrong answer. This, by all means, could show up on the arm in someone who's had an infection, erysipelas or cellulitis, but they're going to give you an erythematous pink streak that tracks up to the axilla, okay? Or sporotrichosis as another example. They will show you an arm with a pink line, an erythematous streak up to the axilla, and they'll say, is this like arteritis? Is it phlebitis, lymphangitis? The answer is lymphangitis. Wrong fucking answer. Choice D, mechanical barrier disruption, is the correct answer. This is eczema, okay? So we have atopy here, the constellation of asthma, seasonal allergies, rhinoconjunctivitis, and eczema. So this girl likely just had eczema in her antecubital fossa. She was scratching it. Excoriated is an important vocabulary word for USMLE. Okay, very important. It means scratches. Okay, scratch marks. So she was scratching eczema, and they want you to know that that can cause a superficial bacterial infection. Group A strep, staph aureus, okay? She's got a fever here. And the 8 by 14 centimeter area of erythematous skin, I mean, yes, eczema, but she probably has developing cellulitis on top of it. So USMLE really likes this. They ask this on one of the offline NBME forms, okay? So this is just mechanical barrier disruption, the excoriation, which has caused bacterial superinfection onto eczema. And you would give oral dicloxacillin for this, okay? For the step 2 assessment, oral dicloxacillin or oral cefalexin. If you just have simple impetigo, you can give topical mupirocin. If you have eczema herpeticum, you need to know herpes, HSV 1 and 2 can also superimpose on eczema. I'm not joking, that might sound weird if you haven't studied for step 2 yet, but eczema herpeticum, and that would be acyclovir. Okay, so that's mechanical barrier disruption. I'll just whip through the last answer choices. Mycosis fungoides, wrong answer. This is a cutaneous T-cell lymphoma. It's a diagnosis of exclusion. Okay, so they're gonna tell you that a patient has biopsy shows T-cells with cerebriform nuclei. Okay, and once again, you're just going to eliminate to get there. This can extend to the blood, called Sézary syndrome. It's a T-cell leukemia that extends from the cutaneous T-cell lymphoma. Wrong fucking answer. Tinea cruris, wrong answer. This is just jock itch. Okay, so it's not even the correct location if you're not sure what's going on, but fungal infection of the crotch, literally, of the groin. Okay, and so you're going to use topical azoles for this. You know the deal. I'm going to continue to make more content. If you like my stuff, subscribe to my channel. I appreciate your time. That's it.